Welcome to Intermediate Macroeconomics. I'm Dr. Dangerous Dave, and we're going to talk about sticky prices. One of the phrases you'll hear a lot in macro is that prices are sticky, or sticky wages and prices. For the most part, we mean wages and prices when we talk about sticky prices. And after all, wages are the price for labor. And while there are some interesting peculiarities about labor markets, we will assume a near equivalence of wages and prices when we talk about stickiness. For the models we'll be discussing, in the very short run, we say that wages and prices are sticky. In another video, when we discuss aggregate supply in detail, we'll see some more subtle reasons why wages and prices may be sticky in the short run. But for now, we'll consider the traditional arguments for wage and price stickiness. First, in many markets, firms publish prices for goods or services in one form or another. Historically, firms printed physical catalogs and price lists every 6 months to a year. Typically, they would guarantee those prices until the next catalog or price list came along. Printing an unplanned new catalog or price list would increase costs. These unplanned costs are known as menu costs. As an aside, the term menu cost comes from periods of rapid price changes when restaurants had to print new menus frequently. More on that in another video when we talk about hyperinflation. While online catalogs and e-commerce have made it possible to change prices very quickly, in some markets there are contractual or traditional reasons not to do so. Second, related to menu costs is the cost estimation constraint. In the time between a project is proposed and when work begins, there may be contractual reasons or simply an agreement for a firm to hold its prices constant. Third, and related to accepted practice, there are traditional or cultural reasons why price changes don't happen quickly. This is especially true of falling prices in the labor market. It is very unpopular with workers to lower their wages. Additionally, even if wages are going up, for many firms, wage increases only occur once per year. And labor contracts are common in some markets. These contracts may guarantee a specific wage structure for several years at a time. Incidentally, the microeconomic models we all learned, you know, where there's some equilibrium price at which the market clears, those models assume perfectly flexible prices. That, in most real markets, is not likely to happen in the short run. Still, it's a useful model, and while we model those markets at equilibrium, what we really mean to say is that they tend toward equilibrium. And that's really all we're saying about the macroeconomy. It's never actually at equilibrium, but it's always sort of headed there. Anything that moves the macroeconomy away from equilibrium is called a shock. A sudden spike in energy costs, a supply shock. A sudden increase in consumer demand, a demand shock. A sudden fall in investment by firms, another demand shock. We call it a negative shock if it moves the economy to a lower level of output, and a positive shock if it moves the economy to a higher level of output. In macroeconomics, when we talk about this short run, we almost always mean the period of time following a shock when many wages and prices are sticky. Alternatively, long run refers to that equilibrium the macroeconomy never quite gets to. Keep these definitions in mind whenever we talk about stickiness, equilibrium, shock, short run, long run.